Dear students, last class we completed mathematical statement of first law of thermodynamics for different process, enthalpy, then the relationship between enthalpy and internal energy, standard heat of formation, thermochemical equations, at last heat of combustion. So today we are going to discuss heat capacities. Consider a system, it absorbs heat energy. During the absorption of heat energy, the molecules present in the system will get activated, so its kinetic energy will be increased. Due to that, temperature will also be increased. So molecules in the system, when it absorbs heat energy, its kinetic energy is increased, at the same time temperature is increased. So before the absorption of heat, the temperature may be denoted as T1. By absorbing the heat energy, the temperature is increased, kinetic energy also increased. Molecules will move in a random manner. So the final temperature will be greater than the initial temperature. So the difference in the temperature delta T is a difference in the temperature is equal to T2 minus T1. This difference in the temperature is directly proportional to the heat absorbed. So temperature change in the system is directly proportional to the heat absorbed by the system. At the same time, this is inversely proportional to the mass. Okay, so consider the system, it absorbs heat energy, the molecules are getting activated and its kinetic energy increased, temperature is increased, change in the temperature is directly proportional to the heat absorbed and it is inversely proportional to the mass of the substance. To remove the proportionality, we introduce a constant called C. Okay. Then C is equal to Q by M delta T. So the constant C is called the heat capacity. Okay. Heat capacity is of two types. One is specific heat capacity. So it can be defined as heat absorbed when 1 kilogram of substance, its temperature is increased by 1 Kelvin. It is called a specific heat capacity. Consider mass of the substance 1 kilogram. The temperature difference is just 1 Kelvin. Okay. So C will be equal to Q. When C value will be equal to Q, mass of the substance is 1 kilogram and the temperature difference is just 1 Kelvin. So now C is called a specific heat capacity, which is defined as heat absorbed by the system or a substance, and its mass is 1 kilogram and its temperature difference is 1 Kelvin, or we can say heat absorbed for 1 kilogram of a substance to rise its temperature by 1 Kelvin. Already if it is in 25 degrees Celsius, so 298 Kelvin. To make the temperature of the substance as 299 Kelvin, how much heat is required? And we have to maintain mass of the substance as 1 kilogram. That's called a specific heat capacity. Okay. Next, molar heat capacity. So this is defined as heat absorbed by the system. It has 1 mole substance and the temperature difference is 1 Kelvin. Or we can say, to increase the temperature by 1 Kelvin, how much heat is absorbed by 1 mole of substance? It is called a molar heat capacity. Okay. What is the unit of molar heat capacity? C is equal to Q divided by M delta T. Unit of heat is joule. Now we take substance in terms of mole. So unit for amount of substance, mole. Temperature is expressed in terms of Kelvin. So joule per Kelvin per mole. This is the unit of molar heat capacity. Next one, measuring the heat capacity at two different conditions, at constant volume, at constant pressure. So C is the symbol for heat capacity. We measure it at constant volume. So this is called a CV. Heat capacity at constant volume. So according to first law of thermodynamics, internal energy is equal to Q plus W. Right. U is equal to Q minus P delta V or dV. So these are all the equations obtained from first law of thermodynamics. Work is done by the system means W is equal to minus P delta V. Now we are measuring the heat capacity at constant volume. Constant volume means change in volume is zero. Okay. So this term becomes zero. Delta V is zero. So internal energy is equal to Q. Now we are going to differentiate this equation with respect to temperature. Dou U by dou T. We maintain constant volume is equal to dou Q by dou T at constant volume. So this is obtained from first law of thermodynamics. We differentiate this with respect to temperature at constant volume. This is nothing but what? Heat capacity. Heat divided by temperature change is nothing but heat capacity. So heat capacity CV is equal to change in internal energy with respect to temperature at constant volume. So this is the expression for heat capacity at constant volume. Next, heat capacity at constant pressure is called the CP. So CP is equal to dou H by dou T with respect to dou H by dou T at constant pressure. Okay. So heat capacity at constant volume means change in internal energy with respect to temperature at constant volume. Heat capacity at constant pressure means change in enthalpy with respect to temperature at constant pressure. Now what is the relationship between CP and CV? So we are going to find the relationship between CP and CV. We know that enthalpy is equal to the sum of internal energy and the product of pressure and volume of the system. When the system contains ideal gaseous molecules, the ideal gas equation for only one mole. Okay. for 1 mole of an ideal gas, the ideal gas equation is PV is equal to nRT. Okay, so instead of PV, we may substitute nRT. Take it as equation 1. In equation 1, we substitute the product of pressure and volume. H is equal to U plus nRT. Take it as equation 2. Now we are going to differentiate this second equation with respect to temperature. Dou H by dou T is equal to dou U by dou T plus MR dou T by dou T, and this becomes value 1. So dou H by dou T is equal to dou U by dou T plus MR. So we already studied enthalpy change with respect to temperature is nothing but heat capacity at constant pressure. Internal energy change with respect to temperature is called a heat capacity at constant volume plus nR. This third equation, and this is the relationship between Cp and Cv. So from this relationship we observe that Cp is always greater than Cv. Okay. Comparing Cv, the Cp value is always greater. So to do work at constant pressure, the system needs more energy. Okay, it absorbs more heat energy to do work at constant pressure. So Cp value is always greater than Cv. Next, calculation of delta U and delta H using the heat capacities, with the help of a heat capacities, how can we calculate internal energy change as well as enthalpy change? So first, we take heat capacity at constant volume, which is nothing but dou U by dou T. So this can also be written as delta U by delta T. So like this also we can write. Change in internal energy with respect to change in temperature. So you rearrange this. Delta U is equal to Cv into delta T. So this is the equation to calculate internal energy change with the help of heat capacity at constant volume. Delta T is nothing but what? T2 minus T1. The same way, we can derive the equation for calculating delta H. So Cp is equal to dou H by dou T. So this can also be written as delta H by delta T. So delta H is equal to Cp delta T. Delta T is nothing but T2 minus T1. Change in the temperature. Okay. So using this equation, we can find enthalpy change. So we need a heat capacity value at constant pressure. So based on this, we have a problem. Problem number 7.3. So consider a system which contains 128 gram oxygen molecules. By absorbing the heat energy, the temperature is increased from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. So system absorbs heat energy, its mass is 128 gram oxygen gas present in the container having the mass 128 gram, it absorbs heat energy, so its temperature is increased from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. And we have calculated heat capacity values at constant pressure, at constant volume as 21 joule per Kelvin per mole, Cp value 29, Cv value 21 joule per Kelvin per mole. The question is calculate internal energy change and enthalpy change. So with the help of heat capacitors, you have to find these two values. Okay. 0 degree Celsius is nothing but 273 Kelvin. 100 degree Celsius, 373 Kelvin. So difference in the temperature, 373 minus 273, just 100 Kelvin. And we know the formula. Internal energy change can be calculated using delta U is equal to Cv delta T. Okay. This is for just only one mole of an ideal gas. For n mole means this will be multiplied by n. Okay. For one mole of an ideal gas, delta U is equal to Cv delta T. For n mole of an ideal gas, we multiply this by n. Okay. Internal energy change delta U is equal to number of moles. How much moles of oxygen present? So we know the formula. Number of moles is equal to given mass divided by molecular mass. Given mass 128 gram. Molecular mass of oxygen is 32. So number of moles 4. 4 moles of oxygen present in the container. And it's heat capacity at constant volume is 21 joule per Kelvin per mole. The temperature difference is 100 Kelvin. So internal energy change is 8400 joule. So this is nothing but 8.4 kilojoule. Okay. Next, enthalpy change is calculated using heat capacity at constant pressure. This is for only one mole of ideal gas. For n mole of ideal gas, we multiply this by n. So delta H is equal to, we have 4 moles of oxygen in the container and its Cp value is 29 joule per Kelvin per mole. The temperature difference is 100 Kelvin. So final answer is 11600 joule, which is nothing but 11.6 kilojoule.